This video is sponsored by Crescent Cardboard. Crescent, manufacturing materials for creatives for 5 generations in the Chicagoland area since 1902. After the first cardboard video in the series, Crescent reached out, sent me a bunch of stuff in the mail. Here I am unboxing all the stuff that they sent me, all the mat boards, sketch pads, artist paper, and then this big monstrosity, 24 by 36 sheets of mat board and chipboard. So let's make something. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell. Hit the bell again so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. Don't forget to check out the design and making merch just below the video on the shelf. T-shirts, hoodies, stickers, leggings, and phone cases. All right, for the sake of argument, let's say that you need to build this 500 milliliter container. You're just starting out, you're a student perhaps. You have no CAD skills. You haven't been taught that in school. You can't render this thing. You have to do everything by hand. And on top of that, the shop is closed because you had too much other work to do, or you ended up going to the bar, who knows what. You got to build this thing in your dorm room. So what are you going to do? What are your options? Cardboard is a fantastic option for this. And one of the reasons that I like cardboard is that it approximates the thickness of metal, in this case, sheet metal. So we're going to be using some cardboard around a millimeter thick, which is pretty close to what you would use for a drawn stainless steel container like this. Once I'm done with my visualization sketch, I'm going to lay down a orthographic view, which is what I'm doing right here. Perfect side view shows me the height and the width, allows me to calculate the volume of the object. In essence, it becomes my blueprint of the actual object that we're going to build. I'm going to use a piece of this Crescent chipboard that they sent me. It's about 1.1 millimeters thick, and we're going to use that for the inside rib pieces. I'm going to cut off a 20 centimeter long strip here so it's a little bit easier to use at my work surface. Then I'm going to cut that into a little chunk just so it's a little bit more manageable, and we're going to use this circle cutter to start cutting out some basic ribs. We're going to make 3 of these ribs, and I'm going to basically cut out some rings. And the way to do that is to cut out first the outside circle, then move the drawbar, which you see me doing here, getting that to the right spot, locking it back down. And this allows me to keep the center point in the same spot for both rotations of the cut. And it allows me to basically get a ring. The cardboard is pretty thick. It's certainly a lot thicker than what this circle cutter was intended for. And I need to come back here with my X-Acto knife and trim it out. But it's pretty simple. You basically have a groove to follow, and doesn't take a lot of effort. We're going to use the prepackaged Crescent sheets that come 3 in a pack. They're a little bit thinner. And this material is what we're going to wrap around the rings. So I lay down the ring, and I measure out a spot on the ring and then roll that out, and that gives me the dimension of the part that's going to wrap around the outside. I use a little plastic squeegee here to pre-roll the parts, and I glue the rings in place first. I add a little bit of painter's tape on the edge, and then I'm going to come in here with my Lurelock squeeze bottle, blunt nose needle here. You can find the link below. I sell those on eBay. And they're perfect for applying the glue in exactly the place that you want. I lay down my white glue, and then I roll everything together. Things are a little bit tricky here. The glue is sticky, and it prevents the cardboard from adhering right away or sliding like it would without the glue. So you'll need to do a little bit of work on something like that. Then I go in, add a little bit more glue to make sure everything is nice and bonded well. I use some clothespins and a rubber band in the middle to hold everything in place. And that should give you a really nice base for your container. Let's move on to starting to build the lid. I'm going to take two bigger circles and laminate them together. It'll become apparent why I do this a little bit later on in the video. So I have one ring and one solid, which is going to become the top. I'm cutting a 16 millimeter strip here, and this is going to form the basis of the top container. I glue on a little tab there on the end, and I come back here with some white glue along the edge of this outer ring, and then I'm going to glue that together, use some tape, get a nice butt joint, and now we're going to add in the lid. Again, the lure lock bottle, super handy for this stuff. This is the two-layer double lid. Let's let that lid dry, and we'll add in the throat or the neck. And I just cut a strip, put a little bit of blue painter's tape on it, and we're going to create up a straight butt joint. There's no overlap here. So while that throat section dries, let's turn our attention to the bottom of the bottle. This is probably the trickiest part of the whole build. We have a pretty soft radius at the bottom of the container, and so every 5 millimeters on this strip, I cut out a series of notches all the way around and create this ring with a flange on the inside of it. I'm going to glue this flange into the bottom of my tube, and we're going to let that set, and I'll show you how we're going to create a radius with that, sort of like paper globes are made, if you've ever seen the way those are made. To glue the throat in, I'm just going to fill it in some glue all the way around the container. Let that dry, get that to the right size. We're going to add some standoffs to the inside of the lid, and that's going to give us a little bit of an offset between the lid and the main body, and those are just scrap circles from when we cut everything out before. I'm going to show you three different ways to make radiuses. This is the first one. I bend over all of those little tabs. I'm going to drop in a little floor here, and we'll take a little piece of PVC, and we're going to push that floor out against those tabs and put some weight on it so that we can let that dry, and that's going to give us a super nice radius. Always wear the appropriate safety gear, like this integrated dust mask with eye protection that I built in a previous video. I've made a simple little jig so that I can rotate the lid and add a bevel to it. And that's why we use two pieces of cardboard when we built the top of the lid, because I knew I was going to add a bevel to that. So I'm going to come back here with some sandpaper. I'm going to start with probably about a 180 or a 220 grit. Move my way up to 320 to soften that radius. It'll give me a nice little, oh, I would say about 3 millimeter radius all the way around the top of that lid. So not as soft as the one at the bottom. And then I'm going to finish that off probably with about a 400 or 600 grit sandpaper, probably 600, and that's going to give me a similar finish to the chipboard itself. The last way to create a radius is by simply sanding one of the edges, and I'm probably using about a 320 grit here, maybe 400 is what I'm going to end up with, and I just sand all the way around the container and get a nice little radius on there. That's going to be the tightest radius of all three of them. Lastly, we'll come in with one more piece of thin chipboard at the bottom. That'll make it flush with the folded over tabs. And that's the finished container. I'd say it probably took me 4 to 6 hours to make this thing. So probably similar and definitely less than it would take you to print it out on a 3D printer, including the CAD time. So pretty reasonable for a student. So now let's check what we built. I'm filling up the container with some play sand, and I put about 500 milliliters of sand into a measuring cup, and we're going to put it in here. Now there is a little bit of the volume of this container that's hidden behind the throat or the neck area. It comes down a little bit farther than where the bottle turns in. So not all the volume is filled up, and it fills up to the top. It's a little higher than I would want, but it's still the 500 milliliters, pretty darn close. So this is a way to check in case you guessed and you didn't do your math. If you are a designer, design student, you think you don't use math every day, you're wrong. Man, I use a lot of math, particularly for figuring out materials and volumes, things like that. Hope you enjoyed this industrial design mock-up build using Crescent Cardboard's chipboard to build a 500 milliliter container. Keep leaving those comments below. Love getting your comments. I enjoy the support. It's much appreciated.
Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking on the icon in the bottom right of the video or below the video. Give it a thumbs up and follow the channel there as well. You want to know about upcoming design content and projects that I'm working on? Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and my favorite Google+. Links below. Also, don't forget to check out all the design and making gear below. Rock on! Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.